Now, the coalition has vowed to safely reopen Australia's embassy in Ukraine if they win the next election, saying that Labor's stubborn refusal to do so has undermined our reputation as a reliable international ally. Shortly after Russia invaded Ukraine in February 2022, the Morrison government at the time ordered staff to evacuate Kyiv. Since then, around 70 other countries have reopened their embassies in Ukraine. Well, for more on this, let's bring in Shadow Foreign Affairs Minister Simon Birmingham, who is right now in Ukraine. Simon, great to see you with us. So tell us, why do you think, well, why is Penny Wong refusing to reopen the embassy?
Hello, Shari, it's good to be with you. Look, it is totally baffling as to the stubbornness of the Albanese government in terms of taking this step. As you said in the introduction, around 70 countries from Ireland to Indonesia have reopened their embassies in Kyiv. They've done so safely, cautiously, appropriately. It's a city that I've been in the last couple of nights. And of course, it's a city that has built strong safeguards, warning systems, air defense systems, and created an environment where a range of different embassies are able to operate. And by operating, they're able to get the best possible information and intelligence and access to the Ukrainian government when and where they need it, which Australia is not able to get at present by virtue of our ambassador being forced to be hundreds of kilometres away in Poland.
Mm. Look, there are accusations that Australia has let down Zelensky and Ukraine in other matters as well. Do you think we could be doing more in terms of supplying weapons or funding, aid to Ukraine?
Sharri, the first thing is that we give 100% bipartisan support for everything Australia has done. When the Morrison government was in power and the Russian invasion of Ukraine commenced, we made sure Australia was at the forefront of support. We were, in fact, the largest non-NATO country supporting Ukraine, giving assistance in terms of financial assistance, military assistance, humanitarian assistance, energy assistance, comprehensive support for the country. Under the Albanese government, that has slipped. We are now no longer the largest non-NATO contributor. Countries like Japan and South Korea have overtaken us. And we do think that there is more that could be done. We shouldn't be sending retiring army helicopters to be junked and buried in Australia. We should be sending them, or at least the parts, to support Ukraine. We should be answering quickly when Ukraine asks for Australian coal and ensuring those shipments go, not faffing around for months and months and then eventually putting money into an international fund. These are not the type of signs of urgency and commitment that you would and should expect Australia to show.
Yeah, I think it's a case similar to Israel, where the Albanese government has let down a nation that should clearly be our ally. Well, Simon Birmingham, stay safe over there, and thanks for joining us on the program.